Hi students, welcome in chemistry classes. So after somewhat delay, I have prepared this video. Okay, now what's about your CSIR NET exam? Please tell us, please comment us. And now our target is the next exams, incoming CAT exam and IIT JAM exam. So we will prepare for these exams. And we know that in all of these exams, in CSIR NET exam, in GATE exam, as well as in the IIT JAM exam, the syllabus is almost same. So we can study for all of them at the same time, right? But here we will see some more questions about the GATE exam and the IIT JAM exam. We will solve some of the problems in the next videos. Now we are preparing video on the metal nitrosyls, a very important topic. The metal nitrosyls are almost similar to the metal carbonyls, and about the metal carbonyls, I have already prepared some videos. So if you want to see the videos about metal carbonyls, you can see our description box. I will give here the links. Okay, now comes to the metal nitrosyls. What are metal nitrosyls? We know that this is the metal, and here these are the ligands that are attached to metal. So this is the metal ligand fragment. If to it a CO ligand is attached, we know it as the carbonyls. These are called carbonyls, metal carbonyls, right? Similarly, if this fragment it attached to NO, this is present as the ligand, then this type of complexes are known as metal nitrosyls, right? Okay. Now, what is the difference between these carbonyls and nitrosyls? In carbon monoxide, whenever carbon monoxide is present as the ligand, we know that in the case of carbon, it has 6 electrons and oxygen has 8 electrons. So, total here are 14 electrons present. Okay? While in the case of NO, nitrogen will have 7 electrons, while in the oxygen, it will have 8 electrons. So, total 15 electrons are here in the valence shell, right? So there is a difference of 1 electron, and if we remove 1 of the electron from this ligand, this will take the form of NO plus. This will have 14 electrons, right? So these two species, this and this, are isoelectronic. Okay, this is about the electronic configuration of nitrosyl ligand. Okay, now there are two different modes of binding in the nitrosyl ligand. This is the most important thing about the metal nitrosyls. This nitrosyl ligand can bind in the two ways. This is NO plus, but in actual, this is the NO ligand. This is NO ligand, and it can have two different binding modes. One mode is whenever it is present in the form of NO plus, then it will bind in the linear form. Okay, this is the very important thing, so you must remember this thing. Whenever NO is present in the NO plus form, it is linear and it will act as the 3 electron donor in the covalent model. I have told you about the covalent model and the ionic model of the electron counting in our previous video, so you can watch that videos. I have given the links of all the videos of the organometallics in our description box. Okay, so in the linear mode, it will act as 3 electron donor in the covalent model and as 2 electron donor in the ionic model. Okay, while in the anode mode, this is one mode, and anode is when it is acting as NO minus, it will be bent and it will act as 1 electron donor in the covalent model and 2 electron donor in the ionic model. This thing is to remember. Okay, alright, we can understand all this concept of the binding modes of the metal nitrosyls with the help of the orbital diagrams. For example, this is nitrogen, this is oxygen, this is nitrosyl ligand, and we know in the case of nitrogen, 5 electrons are present. Okay, 2 electrons are this that are involved in bonding with this oxygen, right? And 1 electron will be present here in this orbital, right? And this is the lone pair of electrons. Okay. Now here this is sp hybridized. This NO is sp hybridized here, right? And in the case of linear binding, whenever the linear type of binding is present, it is acting as the 3 electron donor. So this is metal and this is the nitrosyl ligand. So one bond is formed by the donation of this electron to this orbital, that is d pi orbital. Okay, this is the metal d pi orbital. So a bond is formed between this orbital and this orbital in this way, right? And here this is the lone pair of electrons that is present in this orbital, and it is donated to the sigma orbital that is present on the metal. So a sigma bond is formed here. This is sigma orbital and this is accepting the electron pair from the nitrogen, and this is the d pi orbital that is forming a bond with this electron. Okay, in this way a pi bond is forming here. So this type of bonding is happening when the NO ligand is in the form of sp hybridization. Whenever the nitrogen is here sp hybridized, so it will be linear. Okay, and what happens when it undergoes the bent type of binding, in the bent mode, when it is acting as the one electron donor? In that case only one electron is being shared with the metal, so only one bond is forming here. This is metal and this is nitrogen. This is one electron of it and this is one electron of nitrogen. Okay, so a single bond is formed between metal and the nitrogen in this way, right? And the lone pair of electron is present in the non-bonding orbital of the nitrogen. For such type of situation, this orbital should be oriented in the direction of this metal orbital. For this type of bonding, the nitrogen should change its hybridization situation. It means now it will be sp2 hybridized. Why it should be sp2 hybridized? Because in the case of sp2 hybridization, the shape of the orbitals will be in the form of trigonal planar. So this orbital will be oriented in the direction of this metal orbital. This is metal orbital, right? So it will be directed toward metal. This will have lone pair of electrons. This is the non-bonding orbital of the nitrogen. Okay, so when the bent mode is present, then the nitrogen will be in the sp2 hybridized form, and in this situation the nitrogen will be in the bent form. Okay, here it is linear and this is bent form. So question is basically asked on this topic, that whether the nitrosyl ligand is linear or it is bent, whether it is 3 electron donor or it is 1 electron donor. This all situation just depends on the condition whether this metal will have empty orbital or not. It can accommodate the electrons that is being donated by this nitrogen, this lone pair of electron. If it has an empty orbital that can accommodate this lone pair of electron, then in only that situation it will undergo the linear type of binding. If there is no orbital to accommodate this lone pair of electron, then it will undergo the bent type of binding. Okay, it means in the condition of electron poor metals. When the metal is electron poor, it means it will have a vacant orbital present, then in that condition it will undergo linear type of binding with the NO. It means NO will act as 3 electron donor. Okay, and in the case of the electron rich metals, what is meant by electron rich metals? When there is more electrons present on metals, it means when it has no empty orbital for accommodation of lone pair of electrons of the nitrogen. In that situation, the lone pair of electron of nitrogen will remain in the non-bonding orbital of the nitrogen in this way. Okay, so in that situation, the metal nitrosyls will have band type of binding. It means this nitrosyl ligand will act as one electron donor. Okay, or in other sense, we can say that whenever this LNM fragment, this fragment that is binding to this NO, whenever this fragment has 17 electrons, then it needs one electron. Okay, so it will act as one electron donor to complete its 18. Okay, and whenever it has 15 electrons, whenever it has 15 electrons, then it needs 3 electrons to complete its 18 electrons. So the NO will act as 3 electron donor. Okay, so I think this concept will be clear in your mind. Okay, now we see some examples based on the metal nitrosyls, and these examples are quite important. The question about that has been asked in the CSIR NET exam, and I have already solved this question in our previous video. You can see our video of the organometallics, right? Okay, now I am giving here examples for your convenience. Firstly, see this example, IRPPS3 whole twice CONOCl plus. This is a cationic complex. Here iridium is present as the central metal, and to which two P ligands. These are the PPS3 ligands, okay, and one Cl ligand, and another is the carbonyl ligand. These are attached to it, and it is in the form of square pyramidal. So what happens here? This nitrosyl ligand here is present in this band form. It means these lone pair of electrons are here present in the non-bonding orbital of the nitrogen, and it is acting as the one electron donor. It is donating only one electron to this iridium. Actually, it is a square pyramidal complex, and it is a 16 electron complex. Okay, so here in this complex, the nitrosyl ligand is in the band form. Okay, now see another complex, RuBPS3 whole twice, NO whole twice, Cl plus. This is also a cationic complex, and this is again square pyramidal, 16 electron species. Here, this RuRuthenium is the central atom, and to which these two phosphine ligands, these are the phosphine ligands, okay, these are attached to it. One chlorine atom is attached, and these are two nitrosyl ligands. But here one thing you should note, one of the nitrosyl ligand here is acting as the linear, this is linear binding mode, and another is in the band form. This is the lone pair that is present in the non-bonding orbital of nitrogen, and it is acting as the one electron donor, while here this linear NO ligand is acting as the three electron donor. Okay, so this thing you should remember here. Okay, okay, now see here one of the very interesting type of the complex, that is CO diARS whole twice NO plus 2. Here this diARS, it is a bidentate arsenic ligand, okay, that is acting as the 4 electron donor. Now firstly see the structure of this complex. Here the cobalt atom is present as the central atom, and this is the bidentate ligand. Okay, we are showing for convenience like this. This is a bidentate ligand. Another bidentate ligand is this, in this table. Okay, now you can see here this NO ligand here is acting as the linear ligand. It means it is here donating 3 electrons. It is in the linear form, right? And this is the square pyramidal complex. Now you can count here the electrons. Now 9 electrons of this cobalt atom, and this is 4 electron donor. So 4 plus 4, 8 electrons, plus 3 electrons of this, minus 2 electrons of this charge. Okay, so you can count here, the total electrons are
18 electrons. So it is an 18 electron complex. Now one of the interesting thing about this complex is that when it is treated with the thiocyanate ions, SCN minus thiocyanate ions, what happens? This will act as the ligand here. So it will add here. Okay, so here, this is the SCN ligand. Okay, so we know this SCN ligand, thiocyanate ligand, is acting as the 2 electron donor. This is 2 electron donor, and this complex is already 18 electron complex. Now 18 plus 2 will be equal to 20 electrons. So what happens here? This nitrosyl ligand is here linear. Now it becomes bent. Now it becomes bent. Okay, these 2 electrons here are transferred to the non-bonding orbital of the nitrogen, and now it acts as only 1 electron donor. So it will donate only 1 electron here, and 2 electrons are provided by this thiocyanate ligand. So the total number of electrons becomes here 18 electrons. So this is the thing that you should remember here about the metal nitrosyls. And the whole topic I have cleared here. If you have any complications, you can comment us. We'll see you in the next video and solve some questions from the GATE and the IIT JAM exams. Thank you.